Track 8.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to our show. Our today's guest used to belong to the Amish community. He will tell us something about the way of life among the Amish and will help us learn about our neighbors. Hello, David. Can you tell us something about what it is like to grow up in a world without electricity, the internet, TV, or running water?
Well, I know that it sounds strange, but if you don't get used to having something, you don't feel you actually need it. Now that I have lived in a different way for years, I can say I like watching TV or reading articles on the internet, but I could do without them.
And what can you tell us about the education you had? What did you learn in school?
Our education was basic. First of all, we were educated in German, which is the language we speak at home. This may be a bit of a surprise, but that's how it is. Our ancestors came from German-speaking countries, and we speak German at home. You call it Pennsylvania Dutch, although it is just an old dialect of German with a few English words. We learned how to read and write, most of which was in German. There were no classes like science, history, or geography, and it all ended when I was 14. I did have some basic knowledge of English, which I learned at school or picked up at the market. We also had to study the Bible, and that's all.
And can you tell us something about the way of life in your community and what you liked about it?
Apart from going to school, I had to work a lot. I still don't mind working long hours, and I can carry out any task. Amish kids are taught to work for a living, and all community members help each other. For example, if you want to build a house, the entire community will help you, and everybody will work for free. Of course, you are expected to do the same when someone else needs help. This is nice, but there are also many rules that you have to follow. We can't use modern tools that will make our lives easier. For instance, we use horse-drawn carriages if we need to go somewhere or transport something. And it's not always pleasant to spend 2 hours in the cold without a windshield. These carriages, or buggies to be more precise, are very slow, and their speed is 10 to 20 miles per hour. Spending 2 hours in the cold just because you have to visit a relative is not something you would enjoy. The Amish community doesn't even use tractors, cars, microwaves, or telephones because they're too modern. Can you imagine that? And then everyone has to wear the same clothes, which have to be in dark colors, and even has to cut their hair by the rules. Women are expected to be silent, and most of them have very little contact with the outside world, usually when they're told to buy some groceries.
I see. And why did you leave the community?
I first started thinking about it when Henry, a friend of mine, left. He returned 1 year later to see his parents. He also visited my parents and left us his phone number. I kept his number, and when I decided to leave, I left a note for my parents, went to town, and called him. Henry drove 100 miles to pick me up, put me up at his place, found me a job, and the rest is history. The only thing I regret is that my parents don't talk to me anymore because they think I betrayed the community.
Was it difficult to adapt to the modern world?
Yes. I didn't know how to use a computer, a toaster, a microwave, and the like. My friend had to teach me how to drive, use an elevator, and many other things modern kids learn at home. Luckily, I'm good at carpentry, and my friend found me a good job. I'm still working as a carpenter, and I like the job.
And how did your employers and coworkers accept you?
Oh, they were amazing. They knew certain things about the Amish community and have been helpful since the very beginning. They helped me adapt to the modern world, and we're good friends. We often go out and spend time together. They even teach me how to play baseball.
That's great. And now, stand by for a commercial break.